Hi, my name's Dominic. I will be counseling today.
Hi, my name's Matt. It's nice to meet you.
Matt, nice to meet you too. So how are you doing today?
I'm doing pretty good.
Good?
Awesome. Beautiful weather outside, you know, can't complain.
That's great. Yeah, couldn't agree more. I mean, Odeon is beautiful year-round, right?
It is.
So what brings you here today?
I just got back from my doctor a couple weeks ago, and, you know, I did a physical exam, and he noticed that I'm pretty overweight, and he also mentioned that I had a high BMI. Not really sure as to what that is, means or anything, if you can just kind of like run me through it or something.
BMI is your body mass index. It calculates how much body mass you have. So over 30 is considered to be obese. Over 25 is overweight, and then under 25 is normal range. You should be between 18 to 24.9.
Okay. He said I was 31, so.
So you're definitely over, you're in the percentile of obesity.
Okay.
For a BMI. Well, this is definitely a prevalent thing in today's society, so I definitely have a lot of experience dealing with patients with this problem. It's definitely a thing to try and solve as soon as possible, because it could lead to multiple problems health-wise, such as heart disease, type 2 diabetes,
Okay. And
could eventually lead to a stroke or something like that. But take it one step at a time. We don't have to worry about that right now.
Right.
I'm going to try to go over like a recall of what you've been eating the last 24 hours to gain an understanding of what has gotten you to this point. So just run me through what you eat for breakfast, lunch, dinner, usually throughout the week.
Okay. All right, so usually I wake up and I usually have McDonald's. I'll get like a big thing of orange juice, two hash browns, and maybe one or two of the biscuit and eggs with sausage or something in it.
Okay.
And then probably like 2-3 hours later, I'll have a little snack, like a granola bar with maybe like a pie laying around the house. I'll have a nice slice of that with some soda, like a root beer or something.
Okay. And
then for lunch, usually I'll go out to this burger joint pretty much every day throughout my work week. You know, I usually have like a double cheeseburger, sometimes even triple, depending on how hungry I am. Then I'll have like a side of onion rings, and usually I have like two or three sodas when I'm there, depending on how thirsty I am. And then later on I'll go for a snack, maybe like if I have a slice of pizza laying around, something like that. And then,
it's alright.
Yeah, and then put some like hot sauce on it. Again, I'll have like a Coke or maybe a ginger ale or something like that. Then for dinner, I come home and usually I cook my own meals. Depends on the day. Usually, I'll make a nice sized meatloaf for myself. Probably like
just for yourself.
Yeah, usually like a pound of ground beef,
something
like that, or I'll have like a nice big chicken breast, maybe two.
All right, that's pretty good. No sides or anything.
Sometimes I'll throw in a vegetable, but usually that fills me up right there.
Just meat.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then like usually around dinner time, if I have like ice cream or like popcorn, something like that, I'll throw some. If I'm having like a sundae, I'll put whipped cream, cherry. Maybe like 3-4, maybe 5 scoops of ice cream in there.
Alright.
Then popcorn, I usually throw some butter on top of it, because usually they don't put enough in.
Understandable. There's definitely, I can notice some issues in your diet that we could definitely work on.
Mm-hmm.
What I usually do is try to make very subtle changes to the person's diet that I'm counseling.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not too overwhelming for them and they don't just don't change anything because it's too much at once to handle.
Right. Yeah, so, see, I've had problems in my past where I just try to change so many things at once and then it totally deters me from going on.
Okay.
I just fall back in my old habits.
Well, the one thing I could definitely notice is that you're consuming a lot of soda in your diet, which is definitely one of the bigger problems in most people's diets that no one really thinks about. And I think, do you prefer any other beverages besides Coke or any type of soft drink?
Maybe water every once in a while. I could try incorporating that more.
Do you not like water? Do you not like the taste of it, or you just rather just have a Coke?
Honestly, I really don't mind the taste of water.
Okay.
I just prefer having like a Coke or something every now and then.
Alright, well, you definitely could maybe swap out a water for like, maybe just have like a soda with your dinner instead of your
all
snacks all throughout the day.
Okay.
Just have water mainly. Also, maybe for breakfast, instead of orange juice, you could have an orange, maybe.
Okay. Yeah, that's I love oranges, so that sounds good.
That's awesome. That's definitely an easy swap.
Yeah.
I mean, you get your fruits in. The added fiber from the orange, as compared to orange juice, is definitely helps with the blood sugar.
Right.
So
that's another thing my doctor did mention. My blood sugar is pretty high up there.
Alright, yeah. That's usually related to weight gain and obesity. Those two diseases go hand in hand with each other.
Okay.
So also, what's your physical activity life like?
Usually I'll walk from my car to my house and then my car to my work.
Okay.
Usually, I'd say like maybe half a mile a day.
Alright.
And usually throughout work, maybe I'll walk to somebody's office or something.
Mm-hmm.
So not too much, honestly.
What are your work hours usually? Just
I usually work from 7 to 4.
Okay. So, maybe, I don't know, do you get, what's your lunch break like? How long is it?
It's usually an hour, and sometimes it's hectic, but usually, like I said, we usually go out to that burger joint.
Okay.
Usually a whole group
you
of
drive
us.
Drive there?
Yeah, sometimes.
Is it, would you say it's within walking distance?
It's probably like a mile away, so it's not too bad. Maybe half a mile, I'm not really sure.
Mile.
Yeah.
Well, if it's, that's like not too far, like how is this, is a quick service to the burger joint, like does the food come out quickly, would you have enough time, you think, to walk there and walk back?
Yeah, usually within like 10 minutes they have it out on the table.
Alright, then that would be like an easy way to get some more extra physical activity in.
Okay.
That'd be like a nice 20 to 40 minutes of walking right there. Just adding that into your daily activity will give benefits to your health pretty easily.
Okay. Yeah, I actually love walking too, so
walking with your friends definitely makes it a little more, I guess, fun or interesting to do.
That's true. That's definitely true.
Do you have any, what would your like short-term goals?
I think my short-term goal would be just overall trying to consume less of certain things, especially like a lot of fatty items, which obviously my diet consists of that quite a bit.
So,
you know, maybe soda like we were talking about, and probably definitely including more exercise.
Okay. Do you have any, like any weight goals, per se? Like, would you want to, think you could be able to lose, like, maybe 1 to 2 pounds in 2 weeks, like 3 or 4 in a month.
Probably like a month. I could do 2 pounds.
All right, that's definitely a good goal to strive for. I mean, if you do 2 pounds for every month of the year, then that's 24 pounds for the year. That's definitely would be a good like long term goal. Maybe if you could start to get a little more motivated, you could lose some more weight.
Right? Yeah, at this point, I'm definitely more motivated than I was in the past. Because I don't want to become diabetic or anything like that.
Yeah, so that's awesome. Have you ever seen the MyPlate.gov thing on the internet?
I really haven't researched this too much.
It's got like a plate of... It's got a plate that shows... What your portion size should be for your proteins, your vegetables, your fruits, your dairy. Mm-hmm. And it gives you like a real good explanation of how like your plate should look when you're sitting down at the dinner table, making sure that you have a healthy diet. Mm-hmm. So that could be a good reference to use to make sure that you're like on track with maybe when you make dinner with the meatloaf and to control your portion sizes.
Right. And try to incorporate like different like vegetables and stuff.
Yes, exactly.
Okay. It's definitely something I'm willing to do at this point.
It's awesome. Well, for now, I think that would be good. Just try to limit the soda intake. Mm-hmm. Try to only have like maybe one or two. One with dinner, maybe one with lunch.
Try to
keep it for that, like, for now, that would be
trying not to do it between snacks and stuff like that.
Yeah, don't, try not to have it with, like, your pie or your snacks during the day.
Okay.
Boom. So,